Good morning, students. Welcome to the biology class. Students, we are studying the chapter control and coordination, and we have covered how plants do the control and coordination with the help of what plant hormones and respond to the stimuli. We are now studying control and coordination in animals. Is that it? And we are now studying how the animals are involved in control and coordination through the nervous system. Okay, now let us revise what we have studied in the last class. In the last class, we have studied that the brain has got three major regions: the forebrain, midbrain, and the hindbrain. And each of them has got specific function. Like forebrain is specialized for what? Association of the different information or different stimuli. The forebrain is also responsible for hearing and smelling. Midbrain is associating forebrain and hindbrain. And hindbrain has got two very important parts, cerebellum and what, medulla oblongata. And we have studied their functions also. Okay. And then we have studied how brain is protected inside the skull or cranium and the cerebral meninges. Is not it? Then we have also studied about how the spinal cord is protected inside the vertebral column. Okay. Now, in today's class, we are going to learn how the nervous tissue causes action, okay? And we are going to find out some drawbacks of the neural coordination. We are studying neural coordination, but neural coordination has got somewhat drawbacks also. We are going to study about that. Then, we are going to finally compare between the neural and hormonal coordination, okay? Let us get started with the class. See, in front of you there is an image of what? There is an image of the synapse between nervous tissue and muscles. Okay, the axon of the nervous tissue is connected to the what? Muscles. So it's a neuromuscular junction. See, the neuron has brought some information to the muscle, and the neuron is giving that information to the muscle. Now, how will that information cause an action in the muscle? Okay, how is that going to happen? How does nervous tissue cause action? Fine, the information has been brought, okay, to the muscle cell, okay? The information to do some work, okay? Motor impulse has been brought, but how the muscles will now react, okay? So that an action is brought. We have studied about reflex action. If we touch some hot object, we remove our hand. Now, how we will remove our hand? Some action is done. How that is done? Today, we are going to study, okay? So see, in front of you there is a what? Image of muscle cell. We can see how muscles, they are made up of what? Some fibers. This muscle, they consist of protein fibers, and these protein fibers actually move, okay? How can we do a work? How can the nerve cells can make the muscles do a work? How? Because this muscle fibers, which are made up of proteins, they move, okay? And for the movement, what they do? They change their shape, okay? They change their shape and how they are arranged. How the fibers are arranged one above another. This arrangement can be also what? Change. And because of change in the shape and arrangement, what happens is that these fibers, they become what? Short in function, okay? So as a result, what happens? The muscles move. Actually, the fibers move, but from the outside, what happens? The muscles move. When the muscles will move, of course, we'll be able to do some kind of action. We'll be able to run, fight, remove our hand, anything. Is that it? So what we have studied, how can a nerve impulse action, nerve impulse can action by creating some movement in the what? Muscle fibers. Okay. Next, we are going to study some of the drawbacks of the neural control. See, students, we have reached the last part of what? Neural control. Okay, neural control and coordination. See, we have studied about the nervous system, we have studied about the function of spinal cord, brain, and how they are functioning. We have how they are coordinated. We have studied about that. Okay, we have studied about characteristics also of a human nervous system. We have studied about junctions. Now, but neural control and coordination, they have got some drawbacks, okay, very less, but there are drawbacks. What are the drawbacks? This neural signals, okay, which are part of the nervous system, they are what? They're fast, it's good. but they are what? Short-lived. They will be created and then they will be what? Vanish. These impulses are created or signals are created and then they will be vanished. They are not long-lived. So that is a drawback. Okay? That's a drawback for us, for human, for animal body, for human body. The second drawback is that these nerve fibers or nerve cells, they do not reach each and every cell of the animal body. There are certain cells which do not get what? The touch of the nerve fiber. So how these cells will get the information? That means the nerve cells are not able to give information to every cell, is not it? That's a drawback. Okay, so with this drawback, then who is functioning? Who is removing these drawbacks? What is the answer? Answer is what? The hormonal control. Okay, the hormonal control and coordination. Okay, now in the next slide, let us compare about neural coordination and what? Hormonal coordination. I can see that neural coordination consists of what? Nerve impulses, we already know. Then hormonal coordination consists of what? Hormones. Hormones released from somewhat endocrine glands. The what are hormones? Hormones are some chemicals which are released by somewhat glands, the endocrine glands. Neural coordination, I told it's very fast, but hormonal coordination is what? Slower. The nerve impulse is what? It's short-lived, okay? But this hormonal coordination, their action is what? Is persistent. Persistent means it's long-lived. It will stay for some time. Neural coordination do not reach every part of the human body. But hormonal coordination is able to reach every part of the human body. So what you can make out from this comparison? That no one is self-sufficient. Neural coordination also has got some problems. And hormonal coordination also have got somewhat problems. Okay. So both of them have to be working together. Okay. We cannot work with either neural coordination or hormonal coordination. We need both, because both of them has got benefits. Both have, they also have got what? Drawbacks. Okay. So this much for today. Let us revise what we have studied for today. For today, we have studied about how the nerve impulses create an action in our body. How it creates? By movement in our nerve fibers. Nerve fibers, they change their shape, arrangement, and they become short. And that's why we are able to what? Do certain work. The muscles can move to do the work. Okay. Then we came to know the drawbacks of the neural coordination. We got to know that this neural coordination is fast, but it is what? It is short-lived. And that what? The neurons, they do not innervate every cell of the animal body. Then we try to know that both neural coordination and hormonal coordination are needed for what? Entire or successful control and coordination of the human or animal body. That means we have known the benefits and what advantages and disadvantages of both hormonal control and what neural control. Okay, so I hope you have understood today's class. We have covered neural control and coordination with this slide, with this class, today's class. The next class we will start with what? Hormonal control and coordination. Okay, thank you for the class, and please be regular with your homework, and for any doubt, please consult me. Thank you.